Okay, in this video, we're going to look at Auto-GPT. So in the previous video, we looked at baby AGI, which was sort of early stage task agent. This is another one that's similar, but I must admit, in some ways, this seems to be a lot better. So we'll look at what it's got going for it, how it does some of the things, how it's using some of the language models, etc. So this is their GitHub site. I think it was originally done by one guy, and then gradually a lot of other people have contributed to it. It's pretty amazing that it has like almost 23,000 stars at the time of me recording this. And you can see that there are lots of commits going on as we speak, as I'm recording this. So it does look like it's a project that people are getting behind, which is really good. So it's got a whole bunch of sort of functionality. And the idea here is that it's going to be an autonomous agent that will go and do a set of tasks for you. And those tasks might be quite major. They give an example in here of getting it to basically be an AI entrepreneur or entrepreneur GPT, and it's going to build a business for you. I think the challenge with a lot of those things is that it's very hard to measure whether it is actually doing something that's really useful or it just looks useful on the screen, etc. So what I thought I would do is try this out. And so I've gone through this, they've got very nice instructions about how to set it up. And it seems that they're using a number of different things in here. They've got a bunch of tools already in there. So we'll have a look at some of those. They seem to be really good. Also, it can support GPT-4 or GPT-3.5. It also has its own long-term and short-term memory. So the short-term memory seems to be writing to a file, whereas the long-term memory, I think, is writing to Pinecone for a sort of vector lookup later on, which I didn't use in the demo. They've also got the ability to add in speech in here. So by using 11 Labs, a TTS provider in here. So it's pretty good. It's got some nice instructions of how to do it. I basically gone ahead and put this in a collab and just set it up. Okay, so basically you just git clone it to get started. You go through and install the requirements, and then you'll probably need to do a restart of the runtime after that. And then you can basically just bring in your keys and you can then set up some of the settings for this. So they have a YAML file. So if you run it the first time, it will actually ask you, do you want to change their settings? I went through and made my own settings. Now, rather than try it for something like, you know, make a lot of money or do something like that, that's probably not going to happen in a very short time. What I thought I'd do is just give it a simple task. So here I've basically asked it to, I've set it up to be a master shopper, though with some bad spelling in there. And we're going to get it to look for a UB key at various sites and price it. Now, after I ran this, I'd probably come back and change this slightly and basically give it, rather than from multiple sites, I might say from 3 sites or 5 sites. As you'll see, it tends to go into just wanting to keep going with some of these things. So probably the more specific you are in your actual prompt, the better it's going to be. Now, what I thought is, okay, how would I evaluate this? So I just had a quick look on Amazon. Here's the key on Amazon. It's $55. So I thought, okay, let's see, can it find that information? If it can find that information, I would class that as a success. So it's basically gone and done. So I've set it up. Its role is an AI designed to autonomously find the best price for a YubiKey 5C security key. And so I've just written that into the YAML file there. I also wanted to have a look at some of the prompts. So if we go through looking at their code, the code is actually really nicely laid out. You can see what's going on quite easily. And we can have a look at some of the prompts in here. And this shows us some of the commands of what it can actually do. So it can do a Google search, can browse a website, write and delete things. It can read things. It can append to files. This is good standard stuff that you would want from an autonomous agent to be able to do, rather than just purely fanciful stuff. Really, you want it to basically document what it's doing as it goes along. And then you can see here, it's got some resources. So this is all part of the prompt. It shows it how to output thoughts and a command so that we can see what's going on. So when we look in here, we can see that, okay, in the scripts, they've got a whole bunch of these tools in here. So we can see that we've got our browse function there. We've got some execute code functions. We've got a bunch of different parsers and stuff like that going on in there as well. Let's have a look at the browse function. So the browse function kind of shows us that, okay, this thing can basically get a web page and can then scrape it. And it's using Beautiful Soup to go through it. So Beautiful Soup is a standard scraping library in Python, but it's doing it quite nicely. When we go through and read the code, it's like, okay, this is doing stuff that would make sense. And then it's got how it basically summarizes the text in here. So it's got these things going on in here as well. So each of the tools is kind of like a file, and it's got a whole bunch of things that it does, which suggests to me that you could write your own custom tool pretty easily in this, which probably a lot easier than LangChain in some ways. So I thought this was a big plus for it. All right, so let's get started. This is the main thing of what this was all about. So when you run this script, it's basically reading in the YAML file, and it will ask you, do you want to use these settings? And I said, yes. And I'm not running it in God mode. So it has like what they're calling a continuous mode or a God mode, where it just nonstop never asks you for any authorization, just keeps running and running and running. That obviously could get expensive. And that was one of the frustrating things I felt with the baby AGI that we looked at in the last video, was that once you gave the user input at the start, there was no sort of checking back. If you remember, it was looking for, I asked it to find a good restaurant for a romantic dinner, and it was trying to plan a yacht cruise and buy jewelry and doing all this stuff that I really didn't want. This is better in that way, that it does seem to give you the option to basically, you can then authorize each command. Now, it gets maybe a little too fine-grained with this, but you'll see as we go through. So, okay, first off, I think the first step would be to perform a Google search for YubiKey 5C to see where it's being sold. So the thoughts that are coming out of this are very good. Reasoning, performing a Google search will allow me to begin gathering information on where the security key is being sold and for what price. So there's some really nice sort of chain of thought stuff going on in here of how it's thinking things through at each step, which I think could actually be used really well for good training data for these kind of things too. So you can see it's planning is to perform a Google search, catalog the websites with relevant information, compare prices on the multiple websites, and then make a recommendation for where to get the best price. Criticism. I should make sure my search criteria is specific enough so that the results are relevant and that I save the relevant information efficiently so that I don't lose any important details. All right, so then it starts off. It does the Google search. It asks me, will I approve this step? Yes, I approve it. And then we can see now that it's going through and it's finding, you know, websites, and it's finding information on those websites as it goes through. Now, it does this for quite a while of asking me for different things, and it's going through multiple sites. It does seem to go through the same sites at times again and again. You know, it's maybe going through each of the sites looking for the actual. So here we've just got their products. Then we're looking for the actual key. It's finding out it is doing a really good job. The next one, it comes along and it looks at Amazon. And so it's basically asking itself, what is the cost of the YubiKey 5C key on Amazon? Remember, the way I'm sort of benchmarking is, it can it find that $55 price? And because I haven't told it anything about Amazon, right? It's deciding all of that itself. It also then looks at Best Buy. So just let's see, did it find... Yes. Okay. So up here, if we see the result, the cost of the key is $55, right? And we can see that it's got some information about the key there. So it's definitely been able to find some of the stuff on there. It then looks at like Best Buy, and you can see that each time it's also taking some notes about this as well. So this is where I thought this was kind of interesting, is if we come in here and look at its workspace, we can actually come in and download the websites that it had. And you can see that it's basically got the YubiKey, it's got Amazon, and these changed over time. So I think this is what I downloaded earlier. But you can see that it's going through the different things. And you could imagine that you could, with a little bit of prompt engineering, you could get it to put together a nice report at the end. You've also got the logs in here of all of this stuff. So that's something you could definitely use for testing this thing out and training it and stuff. So it goes through, it then keeps looking at different sites. It looks at Amazon more. It looks at Newegg. It looks at Best Buy. And then eventually I decided, okay, just for the sake of time, to stop it. But I think it's very impressive of how it's going through and doing this task. a lot more than some of the other things that I've looked at for this kind of thing. It's definitely worth you checking out. And I think you should really try it out with something that you know you want to use it for, rather than just say, okay, make me $100 million or something. Give it a real world task and see, okay, how does it do it? And also, the thing I like about this a lot is that you're kind of getting its thinking steps of how to do it, so that if you found something that you disagreed with, you would then be able to look at like how to mitigate that as well. So this is sort of a nice way of being able to do something. So one of the questions that we had in the comments from the previous video was someone asked, how could we integrate this with a microservice that's already on the web? And this one would definitely be easy to integrate. You could just basically do a call, set up a YAML file, do a call to this, let it run. You could probably set this up to run a certain number of steps and then return the data and then summarize the data for whatever information that you are after. It shows a lot of promise in this way. And I think as a project going forward, it's definitely going to be interesting to see where this goes. It's also interesting to see that at the moment, from what I can see, most of this is being done from scratch. I don't see LangChain in there, etc. They're sort of coming up with their own ways to do these calls, which may end up being more efficient than some of the other frameworks that are out there. Anyway, this was AutoGPT. I definitely think it's worth having a play with it. Take the collab, try something out specifically to your use case and see how well it does. I checked the number of tokens. It wasn't super excessive, but you should be prepared. I think in here they say that you should be prepared to spend a full day of development can easily cost as much as $20 in API costs. That's something that of them just sort of checking the code. You could also imagine if you were running this in production, it could become quite expensive. Overall, though, I'd say this is a really interesting project, definitely worth checking out. Have a play with the collab. As always, if you've got any questions, please put them in the comments below. And if you found this useful, please click like and subscribe. I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.